I've said it before and I will say it again. Please do not use Trello as a CRM unless you are using a particular tool. Trello is so fantastic for managing a variety of projects, including deals, including a pipeline, and managing all of your sales and contracts. But out of the box, it is not designed to manage customer relationship data, especially if you want to track that customer amongst multiple cards or multiple boards. For that, you want to use Crumble. And in this video, I'm going to show you a feature which makes Crumble even better so you don't have to go elsewhere to manage your emails. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And here I am within a sample board, which I do have the Crumble power-up enabled. Just as a brief review, not only does Crumble give us a variety of different details within the cards themselves, but it gives us a variety of very powerful reporting features. We can see all of our contacts in a single screen in a single place. This is definitely where you want to be managing your customer relationships. But let's go back to the board itself, because what is brand new is bringing in an integration with Gmail so that you can not only communicate directly with your customers, but you can see those replies and never have to leave your Trello account. So here I've got a sample deal, this Scott Testerson deal. I'm going to click on this. And as you may already know, we've got so much valuable information available to us. We can add that customer card right here. We can also add other important information, such as the size of the deal. Where did this potential customer find us? The creation date? What kind of lead is it? I'm going to say this lead is hot, so I can filter that, or I can view that in my reporting. And maybe I can also record what is their projected budget versus what I feel the deal is worth, or what I'm hoping we can sell this contract for. But the new feature or enhanced feature is the ability to see our conversations, complete threads right here from within the card. So here you can see when I select the mail link down below, I can see a full history of my communication with this client. I can see what has been going on. I can, of course, load more threads if I want to as well. I can either review a previous message or I can start to compose that message as well. Let's start by clicking on something that we've already sent. And here at the top of the screen, we have a nice condensed view of our previous conversations, the back and forth that we've had, so I can see exactly what was said. So for our next meeting or for my very next email, I can say the appropriate thing. But the other bonus is that on the right-hand side of the screen, I still have all of that information available to me. So if I need to reference the deal size, if I need to reference when we have started our communication with each other, or if I need to record if this deal has been won or lost, I can do so here within the same screen as well. I don't need to toggle back and forth or have multiple tabs open at the top of the screen. I can do so right here. But you'll also see that I can start to compose my message from this screen as well. So just below the thread view up top, you can see that we can actually add multiple email addresses. So this can be great if you are managing your Trello and CRM boards with multiple team members and you want to respond from a particular address, or maybe you don't want to use your personal address. Maybe you're chiming in with a different address that you have. So you can add multiple accounts here. Here is whom I'm sending the email address to. Of course, I'm not limited to that, but because I'm within this customer account, that only makes sense. And then we have our subject line, and then, of course, our message down below. And you can see we have a variety of editing options that make it easy to access, so we can start to compose our message. But all the way at the top of the screen, you can also see that we can create our own Gmail templates. And I don't mean templates that you've created within Gmail. We can create those templates right here from within Crumble. So for example, maybe I want to check in, and I've already spent time creating this template down below. Here you can see I have the appropriate links, I've got the appropriate message, and I even have the appropriate signature down below. So I can quickly and easily add this template, come down here and hit send, and I've never had to leave my Trello board. I've never had to leave this card at all. I could continue to manage this relationship and then see those messages and see those responses down below. Now, since the mail link is not open by default when first opening up a card, the deal details will be visible, which makes the most sense because this is where we have the most important information. But if we scroll down to the activity window, you can see that it will also record those messages, those emails within the comments. So here are the last three emails which I have sent, including the last one just a minute ago. So you can always reference them here as well, in addition to the mail link here. Now, speaking of those email templates, where do we go to create new ones or edit existing ones? Well, we're going to jump back into our Crumble PowerUp, which again will not send you to another tab, but keep things here right within Trello. And we're going to come down here to toppings. Here you'll see a full list of the additional toppings in which we can integrate with other tools. And I'm going to click on Gmail. So this would be the place you go to link your account. And of course, you can add multiple accounts if you wish to. You can also choose if you want to enable or disable Gmail tracking and viewing those Gmail threads. And down below, you can see the three existing email templates, including this checking in template, which we used a moment ago. But if I want to add a new one, I simply need to select this plus button and my email editor will be brought to the forefront. So here I can give it a name. That's just a reference for myself or other users. And then down below the subject line and then the message itself. And then once I've saved this template, it will be available to me not only down here, but more importantly, when we jump into our cards. And remember, this functionality is going to be available on each and every one of your cards. So if I have yet to reach out to this contact, I can either come here to the mail link. But don't forget, you can also click this Gmail link directly on the contact themselves. So their email address has already been input. I'm already halfway there, and I can come in here and start sending that email. Last but not least, one additional bonus feature is that you can allow Crumble to bring in your default signature from Gmail. This is not something which I've created here within Crumble. It has brought it over directly from my Gmail account. There is no need to add or create a new signature here within Trello unless you would like to. Now, if you'd like to see all of the features within Crumble and see if it's the best fit for you and your Trello account, I'd invite you to watch this video next, where I give you a full tutorial and setup guide. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.